A good deal of our music production will be done using our computer and using a variety of USB devices. So one of them would be an audio interface, and we've also seen that there are a number of different USB controllers that you'll use. Now, this is great for a self-contained computer system, but more and more, producers, musicians of all types are getting really interesting kinds of hardware devices that they're adding to their setup. So one of the things we want to consider is that at some point we may want to expand our system to include an old school analog mixer. So what I have here is a very simple, very inexpensive basic mixer that can really serve as the focal point for the audio in my production studio. So in this mixer, I have two different inputs. These are for microphones. Now, typically, I would not use this to record audio with through a microphone. I do that directly through the interface. But I have two additional inputs here that will allow me to connect mono devices and control them from the mixer. On this particular mixer, I also have two stereo inputs. In addition, I have two different types of outputs. So one of the things I could do is I could connect my mixer to my speakers so that everything going to the speakers, to my monitors, will be coming through the mixer. So to do that, we'll start very simply, and I can just use the main outs of this mixer. There's also the option if I wanted a separate control room out, but if you're only working in one room, you certainly can just use the main outs. So the next thing that we might want to connect is we might just want to add our audio interface. So on the back of our audio interface, we see we have a number of different outputs. And so far, we've seen how we've used this interface and connected it directly to the speakers. But at this point, we're going to use this as another hardware device that will go into my mixer. So I'm going to take outputs one. I'll put that into a left input here, and I'll take outputs two. Let's get this to one and two. There we go. And put this here. And so right now, anything coming through my audio interface will be coming through my mixer. From here, it's really easy just to add any type of hardware device. So there can be hardware synthesizers, but one of the things you might want to think about using is a drum machine. So what I have here is a very simple, very basic, but very, very powerful drum machine. And if you take a look on back, there's a few different controls. So one of the things I have is audio outputs. Okay, these are analog audio outputs. And I also have MIDI, old school 5-pin DIN MIDI inputs and outs. Now, this device can also be a USB device. So we could use USB for audio, we could use it for MIDI in and out, and we also, currently right now, I'm getting my power through USB. But right now, let's just add it as a audio device. So what we'll do now is we'll just connect this to my mixer. Now to do this, I'm going to be using unbalanced 1/4-inch tip sleeve cables. Since this is going to be a short cable run, it's fine to use unbalanced connections. So I'm going to plug these directly into the mixer itself. And then as I go to the back of this, let's move this over some, go to the back of this drum machine, I'm going to connect this to the right and to the left outputs. What I'm going to see is that as I play this, I'm able to just get my drum machine going here. And so on this, I'm able to adjust the levels. Bring this up. I can adjust some of the EQ on here. So there's a few different things I can do to give me some added flexibility. So that's very simply how I would add an audio device. One of the things that we want to consider is that this is also a MIDI device. It can send and receive MIDI messages. So although this drum machine can do USB MIDI in and out, we might want to consider using traditional, standard, old school 5-pin MIDI connectors. The original MIDI spec called for a 5-pin, what we'll call a DIN connector. And any MIDI device from 1983 on will have these types of connections. So it's really useful to have the capability to have an interface that will allow us to use these. So let's take a look at how this would work with this Roland drum machine. So on the back of the drum machine, as we saw, we have MIDI in and MIDI out. So what I'm going to do, first of all, is connect MIDI output, okay, from here, and then go to my interface and connect that to my MIDI input. Now, oftentimes, I probably will be using MIDI out from the interface into the drum machine, but right now I want to set up connections so that I can go in both directions. So at this point, I'm going to take the interface and I'll take MIDI out from this and bring it into the drum machine. Now it's important to understand that what's coming out here is coming from my computer. So anything that I am sequencing in the computer will be coming through MIDI out and it will be controlling the drum machine through MIDI in. Okay? So right now, as I have both of these set up, I have connections with audio and MIDI going into this interface. So I'm able to have a lot of different types of flexible arrangements for working with MIDI and working with audio. And just as a review, you can use your audio interface for all audio connections, or you can use your audio interface for MIDI connections as well in this particular one.